Welcome back to your free training course for the Windows 7 7680 exam. In this video, I will look at how to defrag your disks in Windows 7. When you write data to your hard disks, hopefully there will be enough free space on your hard drive that Windows can put your file in the one place. As shown here, what tends to happen over time is that files are split up all over the hard disk as files are added, removed, or modified. When Windows reads these files, the hard disk must perform numerous seeks to read the file. Hard disk seeks are a lot slower when compared to reads from the hard disk. If your system has to do a lot of seeks to access a file, the performance of the system will start to suffer. To improve system performance, Windows includes a tool called Disk Defragmenter. Disk Defragmenter will take all the files on your hard disk and rearrange them so that they are all in the one place. This means that when you read a file on the hard disk only does one seek to access the file. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to demonstrate how to use the Disk Defragmenter in Windows 7. To access the Disk Defragmenter, open Windows Explorer and then right-click a hard drive and select Properties. From here, select the Tools tab. From the Tools tab, select the option Defragment Now. The Disk Defragmenter does take some time to complete. Before you start this process, it is a good idea to see how fragmented your hard disk is. To do this, select the hard disk and select the option at the bottom, Analyze Disk. The Analyze Disk function takes a few minutes to complete, so I will pause the video and restart it when it is complete. Once the Disk Defragmenter has completed, you will get a statistic regarding how fragmented the hard disk is. Microsoft recommends that the hard disk be defragged when this statistic reaches 10%. This hard disk is 19% fragmented. Disk fragmentation is therefore recommended. Defragging the hard disk can take hours to complete. If the hard disk is only a little fragmented, it is not worth the time waiting for it to complete. The speed gain versus the time you wait for the Disk Defragmenter to complete is hardly worth it. To start defragging the hard disk, select the button at the bottom, Defragment Disk. This process does take a long time to complete, and you may notice some performance reduction during this time. The GUI interface for the Disk Defragmenter is quite simple and does not give you many options. In previous versions of Windows, you may remember a graphical version of the disk fragment. These versions of Disk Defragmenter would show you a pictorial version of all blocks on the hard disk and which ones needed to be moved. Windows no longer supports this. If you want software like this, you will need to purchase a third-party Disk Defragmenter. Since defragging does take a long time to complete and slows the performance of the computer down, I would prefer to run it at nighttime. In this case, I will stop the defragger and select the option Configure Schedule to configure Disk Defragmenter to work outside hours. By default, Disk Defragmenter will run weekly at 1 a.m. on Wednesday morning. This is done by Microsoft so the average user's hard disk will be defragged at regular intervals without them having to do anything. You can access additional options for disk defragging when you run it from the command line. I will now close Defragmenter and open a command prompt, making sure I right-click it and select Run as Administrator. If you want to first determine if the hard drive needs to be defragged, run the command defrag drive letter, and then the switch /A. This will analyze the drive and gives you a percentage of how fragmented the hard disk is. Remember, Microsoft recommends that you defrag the drive after this value gets above 10%. The analysis does take a few minutes to complete, so I will pause the video and return shortly. The analysis is complete and reporting the drive is 19% fragmented, the same value the GUI version gave me. One reason that you may want to defrag the drive is if you wanted to shrink the partition. In order for the shrink operation to work correctly, all the free space for the hard disk needs to be at the end. To ensure that all the free space is put at the end of the volume, you can run defrag with the slash x switch. This switch will consolidate all the free space, putting it at the end of the drive. This process does take a long time to complete, so I will pause the video and return when it is complete. The consolidation job is complete. The process did take several hours to complete. Notice that after consolidating the space, the drive is still 19% fragmented. In some cases, using the consolidating option is faster than running full drive defragmentation. It can be faster to consolidate space if there are only a couple of files at the end of the hard disk, stopping you from shrinking the hard disk. In this case, the process took hours, so performing a full defrag instead would not have made much of a difference in the time the job took to complete. In the last few examples, I have specified the hard drive that I wanted to work with. If you want to perform the action on all drives in the system, you can add the slash C parameter. The C parameter will perform the action on all drives in the system. Defrag does give you some information while it is working, but if you want additional information, you can add the slash V switch for verbose to get more information while it is working. This will not give you the progress of the defrag job, one of the most noticeable missing features in the GUI. To get an idea how long defrag will take, you can add the slash U switch. This will give you the progress of each step as it is done. If I run these three switches at once, the C, V, and U switches, this will perform a full defrag on the system on all drives, giving us additional information and a progress meter. The process will once again take hours to complete, so I will pause the video and return when it is done. Now that the disk defragmentation has completed, notice at the top the total fragmented space is 0% and fragments per file is 1. This means the hard disk currently has no fragmentation on it. In some cases, these statistics may not be 0 and 1. This is because certain files cannot be defragged. For example, system files, encrypted files, and files you have open. This is why before you start defragging your hard disk, you should close any open program to ensure Windows does not have any open files. This concludes disk defragmentation. In the next video, I will look at some of the other disk tools that Windows 7 has to offer and also removable device policy. For more free videos, please check out our webpage and YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.